inside. Wake every morning, cold winds cover me. Because all I got is close to what could be. If you could see the light shining from me, if you could see the light shine out where you be.
Well, afternoon, guys. Today's adventure has brought me to a local venue, a place I absolutely love, Bee Sands on the South Ham's coast. Took a bit of a battering lately from the storms and the snow and all that sort of stuff we've had the last few weeks. I think we're in for another little bit of it. It's not too bad of a day, the sun's out, the wind is howling a little bit, blowing a bivvy all over the place. I've got a couple of lines out there now. Two little loop type rigs. In the hopes of hooking up a nice place. A couple of years ago we had it really good here, where you couldn't go wrong from. We were getting 30, 40, 50 place a day. And last year it was a little bit quieter. There was a few come out, not as many. I think it was more spotties last year than place come off here. But we're here to have a go. Because the fishing's been a little bit slow because of the weather we've had, sort of bait has lapsed a bit. No one's really got any ragworm or it's in a bit of a shortage at the minute because people's just starting now with the sun the last few days to get out and do a bit of fishing. So I found myself without bait this morning. So what I've got, I got myself some squid, which I'm cutting into thin strips just to tip off. I've got some lovely peeled crab legs that are absolutely fantastic, especially when you're on a little beach like this now. Fair enough, you've got plenty of time, but with lads, you know, up and down the beach, it's nice to go up and have a chat and stuff like that, so I haven't got to mess about peeling legs and all that sort of thing. A lovely wrap of black lug, and these are absolutely pristine top condition lug from Southwest Sea Baits. Absolutely cracking bait there, every time I've been. And what a friend of mine brought up for me today, because I didn't have time to go to the tackle shop. Not a whole lot, but a handful of juicy, nice, I mean, look at that. Perfect lugworm. Perfect for what we're doing here today. I'd have rather a bit of ragworm, to be fair, but lug will do. Again, Southwest Sea Baits. Can't beat a bit of fresh bait. So that's my baits today. You know me rigs. 5 ounce, what I'm using today is 5 ounce Conti lead. And there's no grippers on them at all, just to allow for that little bit of pulling the tide. Thought I had a bite then. Yeah, Will's not with me today. Sadly, he's working. Cracking on, new venture that he's doing. He's getting on with it. Some exciting things to come this year, I think. What we're doing, we're not doing for money to make a business, to be world famous or whatever, you know, some people kind of think. Really, I get enjoyment out of fishing, showing people what I do, and at the same time helping people along the way. Now, there's a lot of stuff that I don't know, and I learn new stuff every day. I mean, I've got Mark Bryce beside me there. He just showed me a rig that he makes up for his place, but I think I'm going to give a go. It's only a single up rig, but it looks real fancy and real nice, and he's had a couple out this morning. He got here a little bit earlier than me, so we'll just have to see how it goes. I might give that rig a go next time. But yeah, what I like to do is if I can help people out, you know, new people coming to the sport, or even people that have been doing it for years and haven't targeted a certain species that I have, or that Will has, or that one of some friends have, that I can get some information then and pass on to enhance someone else's fishing, then you know, that's perfect for me. That for me is as good as catching a fish, nearly. Not quite. Everyone loves to catch a fish, but that's what we're doing. I am talking to a tackle shop at the minute, and again, it's not for monetary gain, because there's no money in it at all. basically, I think what it is we've got a mutual understanding and a mutual interest, and that is to promote fishing to everyone that wants to know about it. Not push it in people's faces, but just put the information there so that if people do want it, it's there readily available. I mean, you know, quite a lot of the tackle shops that I go to and speak to, and sometimes when I'm sat in and you get people come in that don't exactly know what they're doing or 100% or they want to target something different and they've never done it before, and then they ask you a few questions and you can be talking for hours, and I love it. I really do love it. And so do the tackle shops, but I know that I pop in a tackle shop every now and again and I get asked questions. Like I said, I love it. I can imagine with the tackle shops themselves being asked a question time and time and time again, it might get a little bit monotonous in having to explain the same thing over and over, you know, with a rig or a tactic or a way of doing something or somewhere to go. So what we're in talks at the minute is just about producing a few good quality videos on rigs, venues and baits, tackling up basically. It's still in the pipeline. There's, you know, there's nothing too serious, but when it all comes about, hopefully we can show you guys a few little hints and tips to try and get you that extra fish out. But back to the matter in hand, let's get some fish. I'm gonna get one of these in now and bait up. There's my home, all pinned down with rocks. Just waiting for the fish. I've been sat there talking to the rods for the last 20 minutes. Praying to the fish gods. I've been sat in a bivvy here now for 10 or 15 minutes, going mad. Feel like a guy off Castaway. I need Wilson. Where's Wilson? But no, we're here and we're doing it. We're having a go. There's a few people moving up and down. I don't know if you can see right down in the back there. That's Steve Arnold there, just chucking a little one back. So there's a few coming out, a few small ones coming out. Nothing massive, but a nice bit of sport. An absolute pleasure to fish a beach like this on a day like today. There we are, guys. My first fish and my second fish of today's little trip. Little Barbie one. Another one don't look too bad, to be fair. We'll get them on up and then have a look. Right, well, there we are, guys. The smaller one of the two that I had there on the double shot has gone back alive. The hook was just inside his mouth. With this one, unfortunately, as you can see, the hook was a little bit deeper than I'd like. And obviously damage the fish coming out. I don't like to send a fish back with a hook in its mouth, because I don't think they got not a small fish like this anyway. I don't think it got too much of a chance of survival. So this will not go to waste. This will go to one of the older folk in the village where I live, down the bungalows. I'll send the kids down, probably this evening or tomorrow morning. And I'm pretty sure a few of the folk in the village would be very pleased to see that. Nice bit of tea for someone. I might even have one myself. But that's the first one. The second one's gone back. Let's get another bait in the water. See if we can pull a few more out. Right, guys. I'm simplifying the baits here a little bit now. Just because... Well, I've just had those fish on a... I've been putting different baits on each hook just to see what would work. Now that I've had a couple on a certain, well, it's one lug and a little tip off a squid. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do exactly the same again on both hooks now and see if we can get it done. What I'd like to show you a lot is with these lugs, sometimes when they're sat there in the sun for a little while, well, to be honest, they just do it anyway. They go a little bit soft. So if you get a hard surface, like a stone, and whack it against a stone, and it will do it. And then as you can see there, a little bit gross. But what they do is they stiffen up and they tighten up, and they push your guts out a little old. So I'll pull that away, and that's gone. Now that is perfect. A nice solid bait, ready to stick up me hook. So up he goes here on the hook. I'm just going to pull it over the knot, and then I'm going to tip that with one single piece of squid just through the once, and that is a bait that I just caught the place on. So let's get him out there, see what we can do. Right guys, we've had a bit of a mad 20 minutes while I was doing a live video there. A couple of fish come out one after the other. Biggest there was only £1.14.5. But at the minute, for the place competition in South West Sea Baits, I am second, I think. So as long as it holds its weight, I'll pop in there later on or tomorrow morning. I'll get it weighed on the scales in there and see how we go. Like I say, I don't think it's going to win the competition by any means. It'd be nice just to get somewhere there for a little bit, wouldn't it? We're moving on into the evening now. We are at 5:30 in the evening now. That wind has eased off quite a bit. There's a little bit of clouds showed up. Doesn't look like rain clouds, but you never know. I've got a bit of wet weather gear there anyway. A couple of the lads now, Les and Lewis, I had a phone call, said they're on their way up, obviously just finished work, getting the gear together and on the way up, so hopefully I'll have a bit of company here. The lad to the left of me is still there, and Mark Bryce to the right, he's gone now. He was here a bit earlier than me, so he's had a good long day at it. He had 5 fish out for the day, I've had 4 so far, hopefully a few more to come. The hopes are, is in the evening, I'm going to wrap up a couple of crab and a nice big bit of squid and see if I can pull out a spotted ray, because obviously, you know, now is prime time for them really. Normally I'd use a bit of bluey and squid, but I wasn't planning on actually staying up into the evening tonight. I've always got my headlight in my box anyway. I had wet weather gear because I was expecting a little drop of something this evening. So I'm prepared anyway, as prepared as I can be, except for that little bit of bluey. But you never know, one of the lads might turn up with something. And we'll catch some fish, you never know. I'm gonna get this one in now, change the bait. Stay tuned. We're loving all the feedback, we're loving all the shares and likes and all the stuff you're doing on our page. Keep it coming. Show us all your fish pictures, even chuck a couple of little videos up there. You know, the page is for everyone, not just for us. And hit a like and a share on the YouTube channel, please. Thank you very much. It's free to do as well. There's no subscription fees or nothing like that there. It's all free. So just go on there, give us a like and a share, and a subscribe on the YouTube channel. Tight lines. Until the next time, lads. Tight lines.